preserved for the public in perpetuity, but the gift that is the Gardner Museum does come with conditions. These works, collected and arranged by Isabella Stewart Gardner, donated over a century ago to the city of Boston, must forever be displayed where she intended, thus the constant battle happening here.
What I'm in the process of doing is called inpainting or retouching, touching out those areas that are areas of loss and match them to the original surrounding paint.
Chief Paintings and Research Conservator Gianfranco Pocobene fights against dust, light, time. The painting being restored is nearly 450 years old, The Rape of Europa by Tiziano Vecellio, who today we call Titian, a master of the Italian Renaissance. The piece depicts the mythical tale of the young maiden Europa and her abduction by the king of the gods disguised as a bull.
Titian's painting of Europa is the most important work of art in our collection. Isabella Stewart Gardner bought it in 1896. Even at the time, it was celebrated as a civic achievement, something for Boston.
Curator of the collection, Nathaniel Silver, points out the giant gilded frame awaiting the Europa's return.
Titian, in his time, was the most celebrated painter in Europe. It's not just any Titian. It was a Titian commissioned as part of a series for King Philip II of Spain. And Titian paints it at the very high point of his career.
It's a very kind of humbling kind of thing to be working on a great masterpiece. It doesn't happen very often that you're working on a Titian, so that certainly is not lost on me.
The retouching is the final stage of its restoration, which included technical analysis, building a new support for the canvas, and the painstaking removal of old varnish.
It had yellowed and degraded, so it was kind of a very yellow-brown veil over the whole surface of the painting.
This heaping pile of cotton, the hand-rolled swabs used to clean it.
It's a very deliberate, slow process, something that took on the order of 150 hours to do.
Gianfranco has really revealed the painting in a new light. It's almost like taking a spotlight and shining it on this painting for the first time in a way that's never been done before.
A lesser-known treasure also restored with Pocobene's delicate touch, these murals painted by John Joseph Benjamin Constant.
He's a very important French painter. People don't know his name very well, but he studied in all the best schools in France.
Painted in Paris for Boston's Frederick Lothrop Ames, commissioned to crown the grand stairwell dome in his magnificent Back Bay mansion, installed at the turn of the century.
From all appearances, they'd never been cleaned. They also had a very, very yellow, darkened varnish on the surface.
Pocobene oversaw their unveiling at the request of the Saudi developer who purchased the Ames Mansion for $14.5 million in 2013. Since then, tens of millions more have been spent.
The works that we have done in the last few years to record, preserve, and improve on the building is largely due to the current owner, Sheikh Fahad Al Athil.
Khalil Hamadi is the architect overseeing the ambitious renovation.
The first time I came into the building in 2012, I had goosebumps. So it was just a very powerful space.
The historic landmark stands in splendor at the corner of Dartmouth Street and Commonwealth Avenue. Originally designed in 1871 by the famed firm of Peabody and Stearns, a decade later, Ames hired John Sturgis to double its size.
When you're working with a home of this nature, of this grandeur, of this sort of visibility in the city, you really do want to be very informed by it and understand its history.
Designer Leslie John Vickery and Hamadi began at the Boston Public Library, where they discovered the original plans.
To learn about the structure of the property and also to begin to study it in terms of where we could take it in the future.
What the future holds for the mansion is six luxury residences. For the modern buyer, this team needed to add new utilities, a smoke control system, parking, an elevator. Hamadi designed a new back to the building. The common area will be the spectacular entry.
You'll come into this beautiful space, and then everyone will appreciate, if you look here, everything up.
Tracy Campion is the exclusive sales and marketing agent for the building. She credits Hamadi for taking such care in the work.
When it was built at the time, it was the showcase of the city. So you're starting with this beautiful building, and they've enhanced it and recognized it for what it was.
Frederick Lothrop Ames was at one time said to be the wealthiest man in Massachusetts, the heir to a railroad and shovel manufacturing fortune. He was a big patron of the arts, hence the Benjamin Constant murals and the stained glass skylight by John Lafarge, which was also restored.
Until to this day today, even though I've worked on this building for so many years, there's just still many things that I discover.
Complete with secret doors.
But it has a great magic to it. There's a lot of intelligence invested and a lot of great energies invested into this place.
So to me, this looks original, but this is all new.
It's all new. We created this new wall with all this new detail, woodwork and plaster work. Plaster work that is full painted in the panels that you see here.
The same technique used when the mansion was built nearly 150 years ago.
What we saw here is an opportunity to preserve and learn from the past, to make it relevant in today's world, and to create a solution in which, from the owner as a developer, to the neighbors, to the community and the city at large, would benefit from.